Welcome to today's class on functional analysis. Today we discuss condition for homeomorphism between normed linear spaces. So this is the first condition. Let condition A linear map F from a normed space X to a normed space Y is a homeomorphism if and only if there are alpha comma beta greater than 0 such that beta times norm X less than or equal to norm F of X less than or equal to alpha times norm X for all x in X. In case there is a linear homeomorphism from X on to Y, X is complete if and only if Y is complete. Now, second condition we prove, let X and Y be normed spaces with X is finite dimensional, then every bijective linear map from X to Y is a homeomorphism. All norms on X are equivalent and X is complete in each. If the dimension of X is n, then there is a linear homeomorphism from Kn to X. So if X is finite dimensional, then all norms on X are equivalent. So we prove A. Proof. Let F be a linear map X to Y. And assume that beta times norm X less than or equal to norm of f of x less than or equal to alpha times norm x for some alpha beta greater than 0 and for all x in x. First we prove that f is injective, then f is injective. Beta times norm x less than or equal to norm f of x less than or equal to alpha times norm x. If X belongs to zero space of F, then beta times norm X less than or equal to, since X is in zero space of F, F of X is zero, so norm zero, that is less than or equal to alpha times norm X for all X in zero space of F. So that is, from this you can see that norm x equal to 0. This is if and only if x equal to 0. So this implies x equal to 0. Therefore, x belongs to 0 space of F implies x equal to 0. So this implies 0 space of F is singleton 0. Therefore, F is injective. Now we prove that F is continuous. Since norm of F of X less than or equal to alpha times norm X, we have norm of F of X minus F of Y that is equal to norm of F of X minus Y since F is linear. This is less than or equal to alpha times norm x minus y from this. So that is norm of f of x minus f of y is less than or equal to alpha times norm x minus y. So this implies f is continuous. So we have proved that f is injective, f is continuous. Now, if you are able to prove that F inverse is linear, that will prove F is a linear homeomorphism. Now, we prove that F inverse from range of F to X is linear. Define F inverse of F of X to be X for all x in x, then for x1, x2 in x, and k1, k2 in k, f inverse of k1 f of x1 plus k2 f of x2 equal to f inverse of f of k1 k1 x1 plus k2 x2. Since f is linear, so this is equal to k1 x1 plus k2 x2. So this is k1 into x1 is f inverse of x1, f inverse of f of x1 plus k2 f inverse of f of x2. Therefore, f inverse is linear. Now we prove that f inverse is continuous. Since theta times norm x less than or equal to norm of f of x. This implies beta times norm of f inverse of f of x. You know, f inverse of f of x is x. So this is less than or equal to norm f of x. That is, for all f of x is equal to y in R of f, beta times norm f inverse of y less than or equal to norm y. That is, norm f inverse of y is less than or equal to 1 by beta times norm y. Take 1 by beta is equal to some alpha 1. So this implies f inverse is continuous. That is, f inverse is continuous, linear and injective. Therefore, f is a linear homeomorphism. Conversely, let f be a linear homeomorphism from x to y. That is, f is continuous and f inverse is continuous. Therefore, there exist alpha and gamma greater than 0 such that norm f of x less than or equal to alpha times norm x and norm f inverse of y is less than or equal to gamma times norm y for all x in x and y in y. Now you consider this one. So therefore, if norm of f inverse of y less than or equal to gamma times norm y implies norm of f inverse of y is f of x less than or equal to gamma times norm y. Norm of f inverse of y less than or equal to gamma times norm y implies norm of f inverse of y is f of x less than or equal to gamma times norm y. That is, norm of f inverse of f of x less than or equal to gamma times norm f of x. That is, norm of x less than or equal to gamma times norm f of x. So this implies 1 by gamma times norm x less than or equal to norm f of x. And we have norm of f of x less than or equal to alpha times norm x. So combining these two, we will get, that is, 1 by gamma times norm x less than or equal to norm f of x. This is less than or equal to alpha times norm x. So let beta equal to 1 by gamma. So we get beta times norm x less than or equal to norm f of x less than or equal to alpha times norm x for all x in x as desired. Now suppose that there is a linear homeomorphism from x to y. Then xn is a Cauchy sequence in x if and only if f of xn is a Cauchy sequence in y. Hence x is complete if and only if y is complete. So we prove this xn is a Cauchy sequence in x if and only if f of xn is a Cauchy sequence in y. Let xn be a Cauchy sequence in x. Then for epsilon positive, there exist m and n in n such that for all m comma n greater than some n in n, norm of xm minus xn less than epsilon. Now, since f is continuous, our assumption is that f is a homeomorphism. So f and f inverse are continuous. Since f is continuous, norm of f of xm minus f of xn less than or equal to norm of alpha times norm of xm minus xn, and this is less than epsilon. So this is less than or equal to alpha times epsilon, that is norm of f of xm minus f of xn is less than or equal to alpha times epsilon, and alpha and epsilon are positive. So this implies f of xn is a Cauchy sequence in y. Let f of xn be a Cauchy sequence in y. Then for epsilon 1 positive, there exist m comma n in n such that for all m n greater than n, norm of f of xm minus f of xn is less than epsilon 1. Since f inverse is continuous and f of xn and f of xm belongs to y, we have a norm of f inverse of f of xm minus f inverse of f of xn less than or equal to alpha times norm of f of xn f of xm minus f of xn. That is, now from this, so this is less than or equal to alpha times epsilon 1, less than alpha times epsilon 1. It is less than alpha times epsilon 1. Therefore, f of xn is a Cauchy sequence. So therefore, xm minus xn is less than alpha times epsilon 1. So this implies xn is a Cauchy sequence in x. That is, xn is a Cauchy sequence in x if and only f of xn is a Cauchy sequence in y. Therefore, x is complete if and only if y is complete. Now we prove part B. So let x be finite dimensional and f from x to y be linear. Now since if x is finite dimensional, by theorem 6.1 we have f is continuous. Then f is continuous. Now if f is bijective, that is injective and onto, then y is finite dimensional. Since x is finite dimensional and f inverse is linear and continuous, therefore f is a homeomorphism. Now if norm and norm dash are norms on finite dimensional space X, then since identity map I from x to x. So this is actually x with norm, and this is actually x with norm dash. The identity map I from x to x is linear and bijective. Therefore, by A, beta times norm x less than or equal to norm of I of x dash. This is equal to I of x dash is x. So norm of x dash, that is less than or equal to alpha times norm x. Therefore, beta times norm x less than or equal to norm x dash less than or equal to alpha times norm x. Therefore, the norms norm and norm dash are equivalent. Now, if x is of dimension n, then there is a bijective linear map f from kn to x. Since f is a homeomorphism and kn is complete in any of the norms, p norm 1 less than or equal to p less than infinity, less than or equal to infinity, it follows that x is also complete in every norm. So this proves the theorem. That's all for the day.